All right, today we're going to talk about section 2.7, direct and inverse variation. And this is in your text, and again, I suggest you read your text, because again, I don't discuss everything that's in the section, so please read so that you'll have a little more information, which will probably make it a little more plain to you. So again, we want to talk about direct and indirect variation. So they say let K be a non-zero constant real number. And you're going to see this thing presented one of two ways. You'll see the wording y varies directly as x, or y is directly proportional to x. If you see either one of those, then y is equal to that constant k times some x. That's going to be the relationship between x and y. Secondly, you could see y varies inversely as x, or another way of saying that is y is inversely proportional to x. And then if that's the case, then you can write the equation y equals k divided by x. So that's how we're going to represent proportions, okay? Both direct and indirect proportion. K, that constant they talk about, is called the constant of variation. Okay? So, with that in mind, is we have to read the problem, and then we're going to have to interpret it and write it in one of those two forms, all right? So example one says write a variation model using K. Example one, write a variation model, and it says using K, but all I'm going to say is write a variation model, okay? So A says the amount of medicine A prescribed by a doctor, okay, amount of medicine prescribed by a doctor. Amount of medicine prescribed by a doctor. Okay. They say varies directly as the weight of the patient, W. Doctor varies directly as the weight of the patient, W. The amount of medicine prescribed by a doctor, A, that capital A, amount of medicine, there should be an A in here, excuse me, the amount of medicine, capital A, prescribed by a doctor varies directly as the weight, W. So we have direct variation, so hence I can write this relationship y equals kx, and in this case the y is being played by A, the x is being played by W, so it would be A equals kw. That's how we would write that relationship. All right. B says the frequency f in a string. All right. They say is inversely proportional to the length L of the string. To the length L of the string. The frequency F of a string, a vibrating spring, all right, is inversely proportional to the length capital L of the spring. So in this case, this is this inverse proportionality. So I'll write F equals K over L. So that's how we're going to represent these either direct or inverse proportions. All right? We're going to read the problem, and we're going to translate that problem into an English statement. And if it's direct variation, the relationship will be Y equals KX. If it's indirect variation, the relationship would be y equals k over x. All right. And there's something also called joint variation. If I see y varies jointly, let me use the same notation they use. If I see the statement y varies jointly is w and x, y varies jointly is w and x, right? And alternatively, they say y is jointly proportional to w and x. So you can see it written either one of those two ways. Then the relationship will be y equals k w x. So it's similar, it kind of generalizes from that direct proportionality statement. That direct proportionality statement. So you can have direct proportionality, inverse proportionality, or now we see we can have joint proportionality. So with that in mind, example two. Example two. Example two says, write a variation model using k as the constant variation. And I'm just going to say write the variation model. Okay. So part eight. Oh, you know what? I forgot to do, there was a part C there. We'll do that in just a moment. So part A, y varies jointly as t and the cube root of u. Y varies jointly. T and the cube root of u. Y varies jointly as q, t, I'm sorry. Y varies jointly as t and the cube root of u. Y varies jointly as t and the cube root of u. So y equals k, remember, y equals k then times whatever two variables it varies jointly with. So t and the cube root of u. That would be my result. Excuse me. B, gravitational force of attraction between two planets varies jointly. B, gravitational attraction. Between two planets gravitational attraction between two planets varies jointly as the product of their masses varies jointly as the product of their masses, and inversely as the square of the distance between them. And inversely. So we've got two things going on. Inversely as the square of the distance between them. So gravitational attraction, we're going to call that a force F. This is actually from physics. We're going to call that gravitational attraction the force capital F. Varies between two planets, varies jointly as the product of their masses, and inversely as the square of the distance between them. I'm going to leave that part C to you. It's not hard. That's the very easy stuff, the beginning stuff. So I'll leave that to you. It's in the book. So this guy, capital F, gravitational force between two planets, varies jointly, so I'm gonna have equals K. It's always gonna be K multiplied by something. So it varies jointly as the product of their masses. So K, M1,
M2, massive planet one, massive planet two. So right now that statement says that the gravitational force, capital F, varies jointly as the product of the masses of planet number one and planet number two. Also though, and inversely, well, inversely means I have to divide. Inversely is the square of the distance between them. If I call that distance D, then I'll just square it. So there's my statement. Gravitational force is varies jointly as the product of the masses and inversely as the square of the distance between them. All right. So now we want to solve applications using variations. So now we want to solve applications. Using variation. Okay? Solve applications using variation. All right? Well, and it's going to be a four-step process. We're going to write the variation model. All right? And that'll be this stuff we've been doing. Y equals K times this stuff, all right? Y equals KWX. We're gonna write that variation model out, that F equals K M1 M2 over D squared. Those are the variation models. Write out your variation model. Solve for K. Solve for K. Okay. Step three, we're going to substitute the value of K in the original variation model. Substitute. Okay, into the model, the variation model that we came up in step number one. Remember, we got a variation model in step number one. So solve for K, they're going to give you enough information to solve for K. Then I'm going to substitute that value of K back into that model. And then number four, solve. I'm just going to say solve. And we'll see what this means as we do examples. So example three, the amount of allergy medicine, all right, that a doctor prescribes for a child varies directly. As the weight of the child. The amount of medicine that a doctor prescribes to a kid varies directly as the weight of the child. So, research suggests that 13.5 milligrams of the drug. Be given for a 30-pound child. All right. So that's going to be the information I need to determine K. All right. So we're going to do part A first. How much should be prescribed for a 50-pound child? Part A says how much should be prescribed for a 50-pound child. Okay. So, amount of allergy medicine that a doctor prescribes to a child varies directly as the weight of the child. Research suggests that 13.5 milligrams of the drug be given for a 30-pound child. So number one says write the variations model. So I'm going to use capital A for the amount of the drug equals K times the weight of the kid. So the capital A represents the amount of the drug, and that varies directly equals K times the weight of the child. That's what we were told. The amount of medicine varies directly as the weight. So the amount of medicine, capital A, varies directly as the weight, little w, okay? So there's our model. Now, number two says find K. So we did number one, we found the variation model. Number two says solve for K. Well, we're gonna solve for K because they told me how much medicine it took, 13.45 milligrams, for a 30-pound child. So I gotta find K. So it takes 13.5 milligrams of medicine for a 30-pound child. And hence K, so K would be equal to 13.5 divided by 30. Take your calculator and take 13.5 divided by 30. K turns out to be 0.45. So now we know what K is, and now after you determine K, then you can use the model. Because part B, how much should be prescribed for a 60-pound child? Well, we haven't finished part A. So K is 0.45. So now replace, step three says substitute value of K into the model. So A equals K times W. I've substituted the value of K into the model. And now they want to know how much medicine. So A, what is A going to be when the weight of the child is 50? That's going to tell me how much medicine it takes for a 50-pound child. Multiply those two things and you'll get 22.5 milligrams. So it'll take 22.5 milligrams of medicine, allergy medicine, for a 50-pound child. That's how we're going to use these variation models. B says how much should be prescribed for a 60-pound child. How much should be for a 60-pound child. Okay. Well, now that I know my model is this A equals 0.45 W. All you're going to do is put a 60 where the W is. So take your calculator and multiply 0.45 times 60. And you will get 27. So it takes 27 milligrams for a 60-pound child. And finally, part C. Part C asks us, it says, C says, a nurse wants to double check the doctor's order of 18 milligrams. So they change it up. They say, for a child of what weight is 18 milligrams appropriate? So they're about to flip the coin a little bit. For a child of what weight is 18 milligrams appropriate? So all the other part A and part B, they were asking me, if you tell me the weight of the child, I can tell you how much medicine they get. But this time, they're asking me, okay, if the child gets 18 milligrams of medicine, how much did they weigh? So that's a little bit backwards from what we had done before. So let's see how this one works. Well, there's nothing hard about it. So this time we know what W is, but we don't know A. So A equals 0.5 W. But this time, I know what the amount of the drug is. That's 18 milligrams. So I'm going to say, I'm going to replace A with this value, 18 equals 0.45 times W. And now I got to solve for W. I got to find the weight of the child that I want to give 18 milligrams to. So I'll divide both sides by 0.45. Do that in your calculator, and you'll get 40. So it's going to take a 40-pound kid. Okay? It'll take a 40-pound kid if you're going to give a dosage of 18 milligrams of medicine to him or her. Okay? Example four. These are a little wordy examples, so please forgive me. They say the loudness of sound in decibels, you don't have to write this, it's in your book, okay? In decibels is dB, right? Varies inversely. As the square of the distance between, the listener and the source of the sound. Of sound in decibels varies inversely as the square of the distance between the listener and the source of the sound. All right? If the loudness is 17.92 decibels, at a distance of 10 feet from the speaker. What is the decibel level 20 feet from the speaker? Okay. So the loudness of sound in decibels varies inversely as the square of the distance between the listener and the source of the sound. If the loudness is 17.92 decibels at a distance of 10 feet from the speaker, what is the decibel level 20 feet from the speaker? Okay, now you can choose your variables. It really does not matter what variables you use. That's pretty much a choice. We chose A for amount and W for weight here because it kind of makes sense. So we're talking about loudness of sound. Maybe you want to choose a capital A off for the sound, all right? And D for the distance. So the loudness of sound in decibels varies inversely as the square of the distance between the listener and the source of the sound. So the loudness of sound, L, varies, so there's my K, my constant of proportionality, varies inversely as the square of the distance between the listener and the source. So there's my model. L equals K over D squared, okay? Well, the first step is always to write your model. Second step, step number two, is to find K. They gotta give you enough information to find K. So they say if the loudness is 17.92 at a distance of 10, so where I see L, I put 17.92 at a distance of 10 feet. And the distance is squared, so you gotta square that 10, right? That's gonna allow me to find K. So multiply both sides by 10 squared. 10 squared is 100, right? 10 squared is 10 times 10, or 100. Multiply 17.92 times 100, you get 1,792. So the model is K, I know what K is now, over D squared. Okay, there's my model. So if the loudness is 17.92 decibels at a distance of 10 feet from the speaker, what is the decibel level 20 feet from the speaker? So now the distance has changed from 10 to 20. So all I gotta do is take my model where I see D, put 20. And again, D is squared, so 20 gets squared. So this is 17.92. 20 squared is 400. 20 times 20 is 400. Take your calculator, divide those two things, you'll get 4.48 decibels. That'll be the loudness, 20 feet from the speaker. So that's how these problems work. There's one more example, but I'll leave that to you because I don't think this is very hard material at all. If you do have questions about it, feel free to contact me and I will be glad to do the problem and send it to you and explain it to you if you didn't understand it. But this is section 2.7 on variation. Thank you.